This section is called Advocating the Community's Needs. In this segment, we learn why it's important for the trusted committer to advocate the needs of the community within the larger organization. And we'll share some relevant examples.
So InnerSource communities are embedded in a corporate context, and they are thus more constrained than open source communities. And sometimes the interests of business units are actually in conflict with those of the communities. So for instance, the business unit, or rather the company, is usually concerned with the bottom line and also more interested in the products of the community. And on top of that, they usually have a short to medium term focus. And the communities, on the other hand, they know that in order to have healthy software, they need to build a healthy community as well. So naturally, they are more concerned with the longevity of both the community and the product that they are building. And by the way, this is why many InnerSource communities are modeled after the Apache way, which has the motto, community over code. So we can imagine there's a little bit of potential conflict here in this area.
This is a potential area of conflict where the trusted committer plays a vital role. Trusted committers build trust within the organization, and building on that trust, they act as an advocate for the interests of the community and the long-term health of software in the company. They're responsible for communicating technical as well as related risks to management. And at the same time, they need to be strategic and worked within degrees of freedom afforded by their company.
Here's one concrete example which I encountered in my time as a trusted committer. So me and my community, we were building a remote control for one of the HVAC systems that we build in our company. And we built it to the point where we could successfully demonstrate it on a trade fair, a big one, and it was an overall success. But at the time, we already knew that we had to iron out a couple of wrinkles before we could actually launch that software into the market. And when the time came close to launch into the market, we were reasonably sure that we would not be able to meet the deadline that was set for us. So this is where I had to step in as a trusted committer and engage with management and explain to them the risks of introducing the product into the market at this point, and buy the community some time to make the product ready for market introduction. Because we all knew that if we would have introduced that product too early in the market and if the product would have performed suboptimally, that would have been a huge blow to the community's motivation, because that a successful market launch was pretty much what we were all striving for. So this is, again, where the trusted committer role and engaging with management was really important for the health of the community.
Related to this, trusted committers need to make sure that the community and individual contributors get public credit for the work that they do. Public credit is kind of the currency that most contributors are paid in, at least a very strong extrinsic reward. And so it's really important to pay attention to this detail. Giving them credit really boosts them, but neglecting to give credit can be hugely frustrating and have a real chilling effect on the growth of your InnerSource community. Now, this most often happens when the software runs behind the scenes and management is not aware of the community that contributed to make it happen. At that point, the trusted committer needs to step in and make management aware and advocate for that public acknowledgement. You know, generally, public acknowledgement, and this is public within the company, is a really good thing. And InnerSource and open source both run on enlightened self-interest. And this is one of the ways that you feed that concept.
Another common example when the trusted committer should step in and advocate for his community is when a contributor is not given time or permission by his manager to contribute to a community. And there are many reasons why this can happen. A common one is when the community is working on something that's not relevant for the manager. It's not part of the manager's domain and thus not important for his goals. And again, this is also a situation where the trusted committer should step in, engage with that manager, and lobby for an alternative decision, explaining what the other benefits are if he were to send his subordinate to this community.
So in summary, there are many situations when a trusted committer steps in to advocate for the interests of individual contributors or his community. Trusted committers do this because they understand the value of a healthy community to the overall organization. And they understand that the health and longevity of the community is directly relatable to the trust that is built between the company and the community. And that happens best when there's a lot of communication.